Hey folks, this is Burke, and in this video we're going to take a look at how to debug a program using stack traces and how to do something called rewinding the stack trace and using Visual Studio Code to handle all that for us. Now, first off, what is a stack trace? A stack trace is an error that a program throws when it terminates and an exception is not handled. Now, if you've been doing programming for any amount of time, you've probably seen one of these before. And if you haven't, I have one right here. Here's the error, and then down here is the stack trace. And it looks really messy. It's hard to read. And if you can't decipher this, don't feel bad. It's not easy to do, and it's not easy to look at. But Visual Studio Code has some tools to help you handle stack traces and make them easier to work with. And that's what we're going to do in this video. So let's do that. So what we want to do is go ahead and run this program, but when we run it, it just goes all the way through and finishes. And from the last video, if you remember, Command or Control Shift Y shows us the debug panel. And then here's our stack trace, but the debugger's not available anymore, so we can't even look at the stack trace. So how do we do that? Well, what we can do is we can tell Visual Studio Code to just go ahead and break on any uncaught exceptions. So when the error is thrown, just break on that exception. And then let's run it again. And then what will happen is exactly that. It's gonna break on the uncaught exception and puts the stack trace right in line here. So you can see here, it says cannot read property of toFixed on undefined. Well, toFixed is a method that exists on numbers and undefined is not a number. So this value looks like it's undefined when it should actually be a number. So if we look in our debug panel here, let's open the call stack panel. So we're in the format value for display function, but value is undefined. And so we need to figure out what function called this function. And that's what the call stack does. It tells you which function called which function, and it does that all the way back to where the code originated. So if we look in our call stack here, we can see the format value for display, which is where this is where we currently are. And the print foreign values is the function that called format value for display. Okay, so let's double click and that will take us into the line that actually called the format value for display. And this is called rewinding the stack trace. We have just rewound the stack trace and we can now take a look at the converted value. So converted value is also undefined. So now we need to figure out why converted value is undefined. And there's a couple different ways to do that. One of them is we could just put a breakpoint here and hit this line over and over and over again until our converted value is undefined. But that is a very manual process and we don't know when this is occurring or how often. So in the next video, we're going to take a look at how to use things like watchers and conditional breakpoints to make this process a whole lot easier and the debugger a whole lot smarter.